Cleveland. Kyrie Irving and J.R. Smith at the guard set. LeBron and Love are the talented pair at the forward position. And it's Thompson in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. One of the most dominant players in 2014 was Kevin Durant, of course, winning the league MVP. Then last year, cut short. We know that he's now on a mission to get back to that level. And Greg, it's hard.
Yeah, you know, it all came down to health for Kevin Durant. And at this point in his career, I mean, he's got the maturity. He's developed the skill set. He's just got to stay on the court. And really, when you talk about the game of basketball, the rest will take care of itself.
Thompson misses. On offense, here are the Thunder. It's been 8 unanswered points for him. The shot's good from Westbrook.
And early on, they look great. They've made all 4 of their shots to start this game.
Irving against Westbrook. Love with the screen on Westbrook. Irving attacking. Russell Westbrook with the rebound.
Those are chances. Almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Again, the Thunder score.
Already seizing control of this game.
Total control, Greg, and as well as they're playing at both ends, I look for this lead to get even larger.
Here's Durant. Oh,
Steven Adams with the assist.
Quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and Clark offensively.
Well, one usually leads to the other, Kevin. That's just good, aggressive, attacking basketball at both ends.
And the highlight reel replay brought to you by Kia. Good stuff on that Kia Slam Cam. Timeout is called. First of the game for the Cavaliers. You look back at the Thunder last season, and the theme was injuries. Too many injuries to the bulk of their core.
And, you know, the big three, Durant, Westbrook, and Ibaka, all missed significant time. Only Westbrook of those three was able to finish the season.
Smith on the wing. Will it go? And another miss by Cleveland.
And listen, those injuries really did the Thunder in. I mean, at no time during the season did they ever really get a chance to gel and play any stretch of games with their entire roster.
And here is James following Russell Westbrook's 3. LeBron passes to Love. Durant against Thompson. Good on the shot.
Boy, the 5th time's the charm. That's a big basket there.
For Oklahoma City, they've gone 7 of 8 from the field to start the game. Very hot shooting.
You know, every franchise will have a year that is just lost to injuries. I mean, it happens. The hard part of it for the Thunder is that it happened while so many of their stars are in their prime.
Thompson, a screen on Westbrook. Irving against Westbrook. The wide-open look for Love. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Got that one up quick. 10 points for Russell Westbrook.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
Irving attacking. No one near Smith as he lets it go. And a miss there on the triple. Here's Oklahoma City now. This run now up to 22 points to 2. Westbrook wide open. He fires. And the Thunder another 3.
Those are starting to add up. Of their last 5 baskets, 3 of them have been 3-pointers.
And clearly it's about how poorly the defense has played. They've got to close out faster.
Now let's send it down to Doris Burke, who was able to talk with head coach Tyronn Lue.
He told me one of the more troubling tasks his team must do is to figure out how to slow down Russell Westbrook. He said that between his explosiveness and ability to change direction, they'll have to have all 5 guys keeping an eye on Westbrook whenever he's on the perimeter.
Thank you, Doris. And guys, for everything we've said about Kyrie Irving over the years, now let's talk about maybe another area, and that is his willingness to give up the ball. LeBron came to town at the beginning of last season. Kyrie didn't even flinch at the prospect of being 1B to 1A. To me, that was a very selfless way of giving the mantle of that team over to LeBron.
I agree with you, and there was some question as to whether Kyrie would be able to do that at this point in his career, but ultimately, that's what champions do. Kobe did it for Shaq. Robinson did it for Tim Duncan. And that's really what great players do.
On defense, the Cavaliers following Russell Westbrook's three. From deep three-point range, tries again, and the layup good by Ibaka. And taking a quick look here, guys, at the hustle stats for Oklahoma City.
Boy, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steals.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Here's Shumpert following the score by Serge Ibaka. Shot clock at three to stop the drought. And they'll turn it over. Did not get off the shot. 24-second violation. Cantor checked in for Athens.
Ennis Cantor.
And so here is Oklahoma City. 1:10 left to play in the first quarter. Durant just inside the line. Again, Oklahoma City.
And getting back to Kyrie, many felt the addition of LeBron would cut down on Kyrie's playmaking opportunities. But Kyrie was near his career average in assists last season. That even further indicates how seamlessly the two superstars were able to gel.
Now here's Westbrook. Amon Shumpert unable to get his last shot to go. And he commits the intentional foul.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain ground.
Yeah, yeah, completely a brain fade. I don't know where that came from. Just lost sense of time and the situation.
LeBron, that's a two-pointer.
And so far, having trouble converting on the inside.
Yeah, those are the shots you want. But they've been trickling out on them, guys. They've just got to stay with it. Persist in getting those good shots inside. They'll try.
And he gets it to go.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the lead.
To the left side wing. Mozgov, a screen on Waiters. That's a two from Dellavedova. We're at the end of the first quarter, and what a blowout already in this one. It's the Thunder running away with it. The second quarter coming up right after this break, so don't go anywhere. And we got a chance to hear from LeBron James about the hard work and preparation he brings into every game. I think you'd have to say the preparation really shows on the court in his play, and rarely does he look surprised out there, caught off guard.
And Kevin, that's really just the mark of a total pro. And I don't think oftentimes the fans appreciate how much goes in terms of preparation. Some guys get it, and some guys don't. But he's a perfect example of what proper preparation means in terms of preventing a poor performance.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And guys, we've seen the Thunder really take control here.
The roof is up right now, guys. It's raining in here. A lot of threes through the first.
Hey, sometimes when it rains, it pours, and they have not let up from beyond the arc.
So on the floor for Cleveland, they've got Tristan Thompson, J.R. Smith out there with Kevin Walker. That's Kyrie Irving, and it's Dellavedova in at the two spot.
And chalk up a few more points for him there. This has been a one-sided game in just about every area.
Absolutely. I echo that sentiment. Their offense, their defense, I mean, it's all been terrific.
The offensive rebound, out of hand on it. They recover it. Thompson with the bucket. And we're about a minute into the second quarter play.
Yeah, and a big year for Ennis Cantor last season. I mean, traded from the Jazz to the Thunder and finally saw the minutes that he was hoping for.
The Cavaliers have gotten only one of their first four shots in the second quarter to drop. Love with the screen on Westbrook. Irving with the ball. It's Ibaka picking him up. Out of bounds, Oklahoma City takes possession.
Thunder ball.
And the Thunder making a switch here. Foyes check in.
Randy Foyes.
For Oklahoma City, they've gone a nice 3-of-3 to start the second. Near the three-point line, it's Westbrook. And there's another one for the Thunder.
And that's sort of been the story here today, hasn't it?
Guys, they're looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Thompson misses. Here's Oklahoma City now. Big stretch here going 10-2. Shots good by Waiters.
Now this is just getting ridiculous. They can't possibly keep this up.
Can't remember the last time they missed one. Remarkable shooting here.
Irving attacking. And Cantor pulls it down. For Oklahoma City, they've gone a sensational 5-of-5 from the field since the start of the second quarter. And that one's good. 6 points for Serge Ibaka.
They're perfectly content to keep going to that mid-range jumper. If the defense is going to give it to them, they'll take it all day.
It's about getting open looks, and they've used that shot with great effect here tonight.
Waiters gets a wide-open look, and again it's Oklahoma City.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
Love outside. Poked away. The shot by Westbrook. And Oklahoma City again with the bucket.
Clearly, they've been the hotter team here in the first half.
Well, they've been grit and grind, working for those high percentage shots, and quite honestly, it's paid off for them.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, Greg, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it, gritty and rough. But that's how you win games.
And it's strange to think that early last year, all the talk in the media was about the in-house fighting on the Cavs. Goes to show just how much better things are for a team when they're winning.
Fires for three, and again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime-dropping delights is what I call it.
That is a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he's on the money, that's no doubt. And Thompson kicks to Irving. Ibaka goes in. Lays it up, and despite of the excellent defense at that. Well, as rough as the Cavs might have started the season, Clark, they were all at peace near the end. Things turned around certainly after the All-Star break. Had their amazing playoff run, great momentum.
Really did, and I thought the big three found a way to come together nicely and smooth out the rough spots, and James, Irving, and Love ended up being the highest scoring trio in the league last year.
Irving. Offensive rebound, Thompson. Off the mark, and the drop continues.
Really tough for this group right now, trying anything to stop the run.
And no matter what they've tried, it hasn't worked. Ready, I think they just got to slow it down, idle it back, and get back to the basics.
Here's Dellavedova, covered by Foy. And it's Dellavedova missing. Oklahoma City's gone 3-of-4 with the long-range bombs here in the second quarter. They grab their own miss. It's another look. Ibaka. Good D by Thompson. And here are the Cavaliers. Dellavedova dishes to Thompson. Smith for three. And Cantor pulls it down. Cantor's got his third rebound tonight.
Oh, man, still a goose egg for him in the scoring column.
Ibaka, no luck. Dishes it to Westbrook. Second shot opportunity. There's the bucket. Good.
Serge Ibaka.
And that's 10 points for Serge Ibaka.
Those defenders look like they're out of gas. I mean, they're getting pushed around on the low block.
Yeah, but they better rally soon because they've given up three straight buckets in the paint.
And Cantor pulls it down.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
Shot's good.
Waiters with the shot.
Waiters got eight here in the quarter.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Rips down the breakaway slam.
And they've done a great job of just keeping the pressure up on the scoreboard.
And that's why they're starting to pull away. I mean, not becoming conservative at all. Just adding to the lead. I love seeing a team do that.
And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair. Thunder out in front, running away with this one. And we'll be back right after halftime for the start of the third quarter. We'll see you in a bit.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, folks. Ernie Johnson here along with Shaquille. It was all Russell Westbrook in the first quarter. He had 34 points, 4 assists, and 5 steals. Kenny, let's get your take on Oklahoma City.
Boy, it was rough down there in the paint, and they were just dominant, taking it to the rack. But that's what you have to be willing to do. Take the action to the heart of the competition without any fear. That's why this is already a blowout.
Looking at Cleveland, Shaq, your thoughts.
Their field goal percentage reminds me of Kenny's breath. Brutal. Not reading the defense, not getting enough quality looks. They need to make major changes because the system they ran in the first half was not working.
And that'll do it for now as we send you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the second half.
As we welcome you back, we begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but, you know, anything can happen.
Well, Westbrook has been great. 34 points, and talk about the three ball for him? Wow, unbelievable from long distance.
Clark, there have been some fireworks from deep today. Boy, he is just dangerous out there.
Durant, the three, and Ibaka, the four. Russell Westbrook out there with Roberson, and it's Adams in at the five. That's Billy Donovan's five as we get going here in the second half. Shots good by Ibaka.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
It's hauled in by Adams. Well, what a season for Kyrie Irving last year. Huge moments for him. 57-point outburst against San Antonio. That was a new franchise record for the Cavs.
I think a lot of it was finally being able to play with other All-Stars, quite honestly, Kevin. But you can't discount the work Irving put into the offseason to be ready for the regular season.
And pushing it up here. Here is Oklahoma City.
Yeah, real nice shot selection there. I guess he's working on his buzzer beater form.
That's a reach, but perhaps that is the case, or maybe he was trying to knock a bird off of the scoreboard.
Is about right, because I still can't figure that one out.
No, and I see no birds up there.
No. And for Irving, he did come into last year hot. I mean, he won the MVP in international play while with Team USA.
The feed to Love. Here's Thompson. Thunder with the rebound.
Oof, ugly start to the second half. They're still scoreless in their first five attempts.
Ibaka hands it from downtown. Ibaka's got 15 points.
And for Kyrie, taking home the MVP in a Team USA tourney like that, it's a huge ego boost. I mean, of all the stars on that team, he shined the brightest. And I think that's going to help his confidence for this year.
He's really lacking in confidence out there. Zero field goals made so far in this game.
And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
You know, guys, fast break points right now in their favor, and they're really pushing the tempo.
And Greg, defensively, you've got to have better floor balance and commitment to hustling back. I mean, you got to sprint back. You can't jog back.
Singler, he's checked in for Serge Ibaka. And then for Cleveland, Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. And it's Amon Shumpert in for J.R. Smith. Shumpert in the corner. They need this. And the shot no good, a bit short.
Not really sure what he was thinking about on that shot. That is not high IQ basketball.
Not at all. I mean, he shouldn't even have considered taking that shot. Just a poor, poor choice there.
And the rebound and the follow show you what he is all about. Gritty and determined with a soft touch to match.
The Thunder have gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime. 5 out of 11. But they get it back.
Multiple possessions have been the story of the game. And even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
He does not play the score. I mean, he's going to continue to work his tail off on the glass and make plays just like that.
They set the pick. Irving drives in. Uncovered. Tries to keep it alive. And it goes out of bounds.
Thunderball.
Last touch by Irving. Deion Waiters checked in for Oklahoma City. And Cleveland with a change here, too. Matthew Dellavedova has checked in for Kyrie Irving. In the third quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. It's been said time and time again that playing in Oklahoma City is one of the tougher places to play in the league. Last year we saw it as well. This place, Greg, it's so loud when the Thunder are rolling.
And even though the Thunder missed the playoffs, the Chesapeake Energy Arena was as loud as ever. Really helps when you are the show in a city.
Offensive rebound. Mozgov's shot is off. For Oklahoma City, they've gotten half their shots to drop in the second half, up to this point going 7-14. And Westbrook gets it to go.
And from an offensive standpoint, they have just been stellar.
Yeah, really good. I mean, extremely well-coached, fluid, efficient. Man, it's been a lot of fun to watch. The points just keep piling up because they've been such a well-oiled machine. Even though the injuries hurt the Thunder, last year at home, they were still as strong as ever. I mean, a home record of 29-12 is pretty darn good. Unfortunately, they were in a very tough Western Conference.
And that will be Oklahoma City's ball as it goes out of bounds.
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
And the Thunder making a change here. Morrow's checked in. Outside Westbrook. And again, Oklahoma City with the triple.
And part of why the Thunder were so good at home was their attention to detail on the defensive end of the floor. They were a top five defense at home. They had the best rebound differential in the league at home. And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Randy Foy, he's checked in for Russell Westbrook. Feeds it to Waiters. Front pass the arc. And the rejection by LeBron. He kicks to Dellavedova. Picked off in midair. To the inside. Adams. And thrown down hard with both hands.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember G.A. as an...
Look at that jam! Beautiful.
And that's how the coach would draw it up on the fast break from start to finish.
Yeah, and what a finish it was, guys. Really nicely done.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Pass to Fry. Tries to snap the cold streak. And that's an air ball. Not even close. Durant. And air balls the triple. That one was way off. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead. And this one may already have been decided. Thunder out in front. Opening up a huge gap. And fourth. Getting underway here in the fourth quarter. The scoreboard tells the story in this matchup. But we'll see how much things change up here. Thunder shooting 69%, showing you what a well-oiled offense looks like tonight. So on the floor for Cleveland. Williams is out there with McCray. Then it's Mozgov. Then it's James Jones. And it's Jefferson in at the three, the small forward. Outside Williams. It's stolen by Foy. Here's Singler. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around. And we'll get a look at how the Hustlestat game has been going for Oklahoma City.
Their high-energy defensive effort has paid off for them, guys, with more than a few steals over the course of the ballgame.
And also, guys, they take a lot of pride in their ability to rebound the basketball, especially on the offensive end.
And it's blocked. Deep. Kept alive. Second chance shot. And that one's good.
The defense just gets caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance opportunity.
You know, that just can't happen. They need much more effort than that on the glass.
Jones, the pass to Jefferson. It's taken away by Collison. Oh, and a fast break for Oklahoma City. Morrow leading the charge.
A turnover at one end and bang, a bucket at the other. There have been a few of those quick turnarounds here today.
and really impossible to play good defense when you're scrambling after the miscues.
They set the pick. Jones kicks to Williams. To the paint. Can they get it? And it's wide right. Hits off the rim.
Well, he's not necessarily a strong inside presence, but he needs to polish those chances off.
Collison for three. That's good. Collison's got 5 points now in the quarter.
The defense is far too slow to close out on those three-point attempts.
And those triples, they sure do add up quickly, don't they? I mean, they've got to make some kind of adjustment here.
Oklahoma City's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. From deep three-point range, and the Thunder another three.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
Williams attacking, kicks it out to Jones. Goes back up. It's deflected.
You know, he might want to think about deferring for a while. He's had his chances this quarter, but just not able to convert.
Here's Singler. No good. Good work defensively by Jones. The Cavaliers have gone 0-6 in the fourth quarter. A disastrous start to the period. Williams double team. From 12 feet out. Again, the miss by Jones. And it's Oklahoma City's ball. Good momentum, 14 straight points.
Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition, to attack when it's there, because oftentimes you can beat the defense down the floor.
They get it back. Pass to Mozgov. Tough break there, shot after shot. They couldn't get anything to fall. Cantor. An absolute bomb from three-point range.
Not shy from outside. There's no doubt about that. Spreading the floor and getting them up.
Love the mentality there, I tell you. I know I've never coached, but, man, playing to win and being aggressive even with the lead as opposed to being safe and going into prevent offense, I'll take the former all day long. Play to win.
Wow, fired that bounce pass in there beautifully.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find some, you're right. And Foy kicks to Collison. From 13, and there's another one for the Thunder.
His switch has definitely been flipped to on this quarter, guys.
Inside, here's Jones. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Singler's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
No doubt the quarter just not going his way. Still scoreless.
And it's Foy missing. Cleveland's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Shot to stop the drought. The Thunder pull it in. Morrow's got three rebounds now in this one.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout. Big-time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a gaudy win for Oklahoma City.
And Clark, their hard work on the glass paid off.
You know, they both are excellent rebounding teams. I thought it was a tough battle underneath both ways.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for Russell Westbrook. He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
Ball's knocked loose, stolen by Collison. Goes up, and he caps off the fast break with a monster slam.
And they're not finished just yet. They're going to make sure about this win.
Yeah, not taking any chances, Greg. This is how you close a game out. Textbook.
The pass to Mozgov. Can't get it to go. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. From deep. Cantor's shot is off.
And sometimes we all just want to show people that we have the range.
Yeah, you're speaking from experience. We already know how good his range is. He shouldn't be firing from that deep, though.
Mm-hmm.
Now here's Williams. Defense is right there. The floater. He takes it up and lays it in.
Guys, that time he went for the fancy finish for us there, man. That was sweet.
And they can just dribble the ball until the buzzer.
Yeah, exactly. They got to be happy with the outcome here.
Elated, you're right. Outside Collison from downtown. That's good.
The fans are just loving what's going on here tonight. A really good win for the home team.
It sure is. I mean, they kept this crowd in the game, gave them plenty to cheer about, and really used that home court advantage to their advantage.
So no problem for Oklahoma City as they get the win. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but you have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
Yeah, they were the superior team in every department, in every category to me, Kevin. I know their fans loved it and appreciate it.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, guys, I'm here with Russell Westbrook. And, Russell, obviously the fans were loving this win here tonight. What was your mindset coming into this particular matchup?
Just trying to come out and play our game. You know, we're a good team, especially at home. Did a good job of playing team ball tonight.
The fans were delighted, Russell. Thank you so much. Guys, back to you.
Thank you, Doris. Great interview once again. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, Clark Kellogg, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Kevin, much appreciated, and now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Russell Westbrook. We watched a marvelous third quarter from him, and he basically put the game on ice at that point. And from that point on, they were in control. Let's get your opinion, Shaq.
I don't know if there's a fan base that loves their star more than this crowd.
Wow.
I'm getting jealous, and he feeds off that support. Once they got behind him, he became unstoppable, man!
In terms of three-point shooting, this could be framed as a historic performance. Hitting that many three-point shots in a single game is borderline impossible. The pressure was off the rest of the guys offensively. They just had to worry about getting him the ball and setting screens. Then it was bombs away.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. Hope you enjoyed the show. From myself, Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, have a wonderful evening.